One of the main reasons that we feed our wild birds is to supplement their diet, what they would normally find in the wild. We want to give them food during the winter that will give them plenty of protein so they can put on body fat so that they can survive the winter, survive the cold temperatures. And then there's also the enjoyment of doing something for wildlife. And birds are very receptive to feeders. They quickly recognize feeders and take advantage of them. Starting in probably October, when we start getting most of our winter birds, as they start moving down, migrating into this area, and spending the winter with us, and then maybe running on through March or April. Some of the more common birds in South Carolina that would come to your feeder would be Northern Cardinal, Carolina Chickadee, Tufted Titmouse, also Red-Bellied Woodpeckers, Downy Woodpeckers, Blue Jays, Mourning Doves. The list just goes on and on. Those are probably some of the more common ones. Some of the non-typical birds would be species that we refer to as interruptive species. These are species like purple finches, pine siskins, evening grosbeaks, that during very cold weather will come down to South Carolina. They normally don't do that. But in years where it's very cold and they're looking for food, we'll find them in South Carolina and they'll come to the feeders. A lot of birds will come in just to check out what's going on, and the idea is the more eyes out there looking for food, the more that's likely to be found. And even if you're not a seed-eating bird, you may be attracted to some other items for food. Carolina wrens will come to feeders. They tend to come to the feeders that offer suet. They're not a seed-eating bird. People may see them at their seed feeders, but usually they're kind of scratching through the seed, maybe looking for insects that might be in there.
Lex, let's talk about the different types of feeders that folks have available to them. And I assume that these are some of the types of feeders that you use here.
Correct. We have a bird feeding demonstration area here at the Clemson University Research and Education Center at Sandhill. Mm-hmm. And a lot of these feeders that we'll be looking at today are feeders that we have here at the site. And they're also some of the best feeders that people can use in their own backyard.
Okay, great.
And probably the number one feeder, if you wanted to choose one feeder to put up in your backyard, it would probably would be this tube feeder. Mm-hmm. And the one thing you think about when you get a feeder is you want a feeder that's easy to clean, and you want a feeder that's going to offer the food in the best way so that it doesn't get wet or and it also the birds have access to it, mm-hmm. have easy access to it. This is the number one feeder, and then also if you wanted to offer the number one seed, you probably would want to offer this sunflower seed. And this is what we call black oil sunflower. Mm-hmm. And it's a very small seed, and we have two types of sunflower seed. We've got this black oil, and then we've got a stripe, which is about twice this size.
Right.
And the one thing is this really small seed, it just makes it so much easier for the little chickadees and titmice, the smaller birds, to break it open mm-hmm. and get to it. So if you had to choose one food, this would be it.
The black oil sunflower.
The black oil. It also has lots of protein and it gives them lots of fat uh-huh. so they can, pack on the pounds.
And that's really why we're feeding them in the wintertime.
Correct. Okay. Because we want to supplement what they're normally getting in the wild. So to help them kind of build up their body fat and survive the winter. This is another tube feeder, but this one it's kind of specialized. This is what we call one of the finch feeders, and it's mm-hmm. primarily for house finches and goldfinches.
Yeah.
And those birds tend to like the seed we call thistle.
Okay.
But you can also offer it in little feeders they call socks. There's a little mesh bag, and you just fill the seed up in there, and the goldfinches just kind of hang all over it. And mm-hmm. goldfinches are really good about clambering around on things, and they'll hang yeah. upside down and feed, so it's kind of entertaining
yeah.
To have them at your feeder. Mm-hmm. But it's not the thistle that you find growing along the roadside and in fields, in South Carolina. This actually comes from Africa.
Oh, that's interesting.
Mm-hmm. And it's a very small seed, and that's why...
Just feel that.
Mm-hmm.
It's really tiny.
It is, and that's why you have this the specialized feeder to offer that seed. If you were to put this seed, this thistle seed in this feeder, it would probably
just pour out. Yeah.
So you have this little specialized opening on here, and the bird's beaks are small enough that they can actually reach in between there and mm-hmm. Extract the seed. The next seed I'm going to talk about is the, this is a mixed seed, and you'll see this seed has several different items in it, and it's got a lot of the black oil sunflower,
mm-hmm.
and you can see it also has a little bit of the striped sunflower seed, which was that's the largest seed. It also has this little white seed that we call safflower.
Okay.
And safflower is a seed that just came onto the market quite a few years ago, and some of the bird feeders were realizing that some of the birds were starting to enjoy this seed or eat this seed, and the one thing they found out is that squirrels don't eat safflower.
Oh.
So this is a good feeder, a good seed that you can put in your feeder, and you can hang it anywhere in your yard and not have to worry about the squirrels chewing into your feeder to extract the seed.
So Lex, which feeder would you use this mix with the sunflower and the millet?
Okay, I probably wouldn't use a tube feeder just because the little millet seeds would probably spill out.
Mm-hmm.
So I would move over and use one of these feeders. And this is a hopper feeder, what they call a hopper feeder. And so this feeder is going to hold a lot of seed. It's got this whole little reservoir right here, and it dispenses out of the bottom.
Yeah.
So they can just eat away, and it'll slowly go down. The one nice feature about a lot of these feeders now is that they have this wire bottom.
Mm-hmm.
So now when it rains and the seed gets wet, it'll quickly dry.
Yeah.
And it doesn't sit on wood.
That's nice.
Yeah, the wood tends to hold moisture and then keeps the seeds wet.
Right.
So a lot of the feeders now have this nice wire bottom. That way air gets underneath the seed and on top, and it dries much faster.
Mm-hmm.
So this would be a good feeder to offer the mixed seed.
Okay.
And also another good feeder would be what we call a platform feeder. And that's this type of feeder. And you can put this feeder on a pole. Sometimes you can get them where they hang.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just a large surface area. Again, it's got that wire.
Yeah.
Here that allows for good drainage and allows the seeds to dry quickly. And it also has a lot of surface area, so a lot of birds can feed at this feeder at one time.
Mm-hmm.
And with that large sunflower seed that's in there, it'll also attract the cardinals, the blue jays, and doves. And again, you've got a large surface area for a lot of birds to feed.
Lex, we've covered a lot of information for folks about feeding birds in the wintertime. If you would, just go over the main points that you want people to remember.
Okay, one of the main things is your feeder. You want to choose a feeder that will keep the food fairly dry.
Mm-hmm.
You want to choose a feeder that's going to offer the food easily to the birds. And you want to choose your food that is going to provide the best nutrition for the birds.
Right.
And you also want to offer fresh water, not just for drinking, but for bathing, because they need to keep their feathers clean.
Mm-hmm.
You also want to choose the correct site for your feeders. Like the feeder above us is in a nice open area, so as the birds sit there at the feeder, they can see what's going on around them and can watch for predators.
Okay.
And at the same time, you want to provide some cover, like what's behind us, some of this brush, where the birds can, if they do see a predator, they can quickly dive in for cover.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Well, let's go fill the other feeders.
Okay.